Hello, I'm Sarah Milliken and I was a finalist in 2005 in the New Comedy Awards. In my head I won, but somebody called Tom Allen was there as well and apparently did quite well. I came second, but I'm still quite proud. I got divorced and decided to just have a go at some things that I fancy doing, and one of those things was stand-up. One of the other things was moving back in with my parents. That was one of the things I really fancied doing. Not quite so much. Sort of byproduct, really. And I got up on a stage and told some stories about my divorce and about moving back in with my family, and people laughed. And it made me feel less alone and more accepted. And I then decided that while he didn't love me anymore, all of these strangers did. And I got slightly addicted to that feeling, and I'm still doing it now. My first actual stand-up gig, I did a couple of workshopy things, but my first actual stand-up gig was a really rough pub in Newcastle where they all sat with their arms folded and I had a back wing top on, no idea. I dressed as if I was going to a discotheque, no idea what you wear for stand-up. And I did 5 minutes and they didn't laugh for the first 2.5, and then I did a joke about my dad and it went from complete silence and animosity, to be honest, to this woof of laughter. And I thought, oh, I like this. And then I went into the loos afterwards and jumped up and down because I felt like I'd achieved something huge. To be a stand-up, you just have to have the bottle to get on stage. To be a good stand-up, that's something different. You have to be funny, point one, and really hard-working, and like trains, and not mind crying on trains, and you have to be good at showers. I'm really good at figuring out other people's showers from having slept on so many sofas and in hotel rooms. So it almost feels a little bit like what it must be like to be promiscuous, because I can look at anyone and go, it's a Triton 3000, I don't know what I would do that one. So I think you have to be good at showers as well as the funny stuff. I don't like telling people my pre-show routine because it makes me look like a nut job. I always have a proper last wee. Like I might do like a few wees, but then I'll have the big one. That'll be the last wee. And I check my nose. I blow my nose and then I check to make sure. Because I think if you came out to an audience and they didn't laugh, one of the things that the reasons they didn't laugh shouldn't be that you had something hanging, you know. So that's one of the things. Everybody who can make an audience laugh without tricks within a really scary audience. So whether it's an art centre and they're quite stiff, or whether it's Stag and Hens and they're quite leery and they're already hammered by the time you go on. Anybody who can control a room with words alone. So no juggling, no music, no guitars, six string applause machine, nothing like that. Anybody who can control a room is my comedy hero, because it's a really hard job. And I'm in that position now where I'm touring, so I'm sort of slightly off that circuit now. And I worry that if I have to go back on, that I would have lost my chops. You've got to make sure you keep your chops ready. So, you know, every comic who works a weekend club and nails it with just words is the best that they can be. They're the best comics out there. It's not the ones you see on the telly necessarily. It's the ones that are doing it every weekend and controlling really hard rooms.
We're looking for the comedy star of the future. If you think that's you, go to bbc.co.uk/radio2/comedy.